Halloween. I love Halloween. It's one of my favorite times of the year. It lasts like 2 months. There's a lot of candy at every grocery store. You can get pumpkins in your house. What else could you possibly need? But you know who else loves Halloween? YouTubers. But in this instance, Halloween is an allegory for money. Oh no! Oh man, I blew out one of my wicks. Shit! So today we're gonna be looking at some Halloween pranks just to really see how bad you could ruin this holiday for me. I'm scared already, but I'm afraid I'm woefully underdressed, so I'm gonna go have to go get a Halloween costume at the Halloween store for Halloween.
I can't forget this. I don't know what I want to do yet. I saw on the Spirit Halloween website there was a Flamin' Hot Cheeto. That looked pretty good. Let's go. Hi-ya! Let's go get our Halloween costume. Some winners here. Just funny. Okay, that's pretty good. That's not scary. No, that's scary.
Okay, Spirit Halloween review. It's hot in there. There's a lot of people. I couldn't film as much as I wanted to, but pretty good. They have pretty good hats, I found. Look at this. This is just a hat that I would wear. I mean, come on. They also had some nice throw blankets. I did not get one. I kind of wanted one though. Too much clown stuff. And I feel like that's pretty consistent. Like, I feel like that's always a thing with Halloween, is that like people dress up as like scary clown or whatever. And I feel like since that 2016 like prank era where people were dressing up as clowns and like harassing people, I feel like it's only gotten worse. Like every Halloween, there's just so much clown shit. Clowns are not scary. I don't find clowns scary. Like, yeah, they're creepy, but they're not scary. Like if a clown came up to me, he would catch these fucking hands so fast. He would literally die on the spot. Like, I would beat the absolute shit out of a clown. And I don't think it'd be very hard. So.
I decided this year to be Oscar the Grouch for Halloween for no particular reason. Please don't read into it. And I swear to God, I will strike you down if any of you in the comments calls me Ethan the Grouch. I swear to God. So let's go ahead and get started. Can you tell it's a skull? I put juice in there because it looks like blood. What's that you're watching on your computer, honey? Oh, I'm just watching a 22-year-old man in a Oscar the Grouch snuggie costume drink some grape juice. Happy Halloween. So the first Halloween prank we're gonna be looking at today is from a channel called Shane and Liana. What grabbed me about this video is how weird the thumbnail is. This does not read like a prank to me. It's just like a monster. Like, what's the prank? Like, oh, I fucking killed and ate somebody. Gotcha. What would happen if I killed and ate somebody? Let's find out. I also love that whatever this like creature is wrote, I eat you on the walls. If I was ever a creature, I would probably do that too. Just like, fair warning, I eat you. Guys, I want to make sure that everybody knows I eat you. You know, there's nothing I can do about it. I eat you. If you're down, I could take you on a cruise. If you're down, I might put an ass on snows. If you're down. What the fuck? What is this total shift? You go from a creature tearing some animal apart in the kitchen to fucking Bruno Mars and like a minute of stock footage of just like a family playing.
So today we're gonna be doing a horror prank on Shane. Ma, tell them what you started doing.
Alright.
So guys, she put base on her face to make
I'm trying to make myself a little
pale. Pale. A lot pale.
A lot paler than usual.
Mm-hmm.
So guys, she's either gonna use the squirrel in her mouth or a piece of meat. So we're not sure yet. We're still deciding which one you want to use.
They don't even have a finalized plan. She's either going to use a squirrel or a piece of meat. I don't even know. That's the crazy part of the prank, is that we didn't even plan it. Also, that's not a squirrel. It's like a ferret or something. That is so clearly not a squirrel.
Back in a few, he's not going to be here. We're just right. Getting ready.
I need to be in a corner.
Okay.
In a corner. Where it's going to close all of this, because you can tell.
Yeah, I got to clean everything up, of course.
Which way do you think he's gonna walk in?
Definitely not through the garage. Either the back door or the front, but most likely the front.
This video sucks. It is so boring. They're just sitting here planning the video. Show me the video.
Is a war going on between son and daughter? And I gotta get my daughter too. So just stay tuned, alright?
No, guys, but listen. Shane is gonna be home in a few minutes.
The mom and her daughter, for some reason, have zero on-camera chemistry. Like, the mom's actually pretty decent. Like, she's kind of talking about what she's doing in the video. And then the daughter interrupts with, no, we're talking about something else now. Like, the mom is literally like, stay tuned, I got more videos planned. Like, very normal YouTube shit. And the daughter's like, no, shut the fuck up. He's coming home. Okay, it's going on way too long. Like, you gotta be like, you're pranked. But then, you know, I'm sure she kind of realized in the moment that like, oh, that's kind of a really weak prank. And also his reaction is very tame. So they didn't want to cut the prank short. Meanwhile, he's like, hey man, relax. Like, chill the fuck out. What are you doing? This is crazy. Stop. Listen. I love that she's like offering some of the meat. She's like, hey, you want some, bro? This shit's delicious. Okay, apparently he just fucking teleported. Why wouldn't they show that? That sounds exciting. Like, he had to run past her. What the fuck? He was throwing water on her? Like, hey, quit it! Stop! And then he grabs a pan, and then now she realizes, okay, now we finally have something to put in the thumbnail so I can call the prank off. I mean, this mom knows her YouTube. I can't lie. This mom knows what she's doing. She's content. She's content.
Shane is a prank. Shane, I'm sorry, is a prank. Shane, that's not a real squirrel. It's fake. I think I scared.
And what is this? What is this dance she's doing in the doorway? If we're to believe that this is real, this woman's husband has been fucking terrified and has had probably one of the worst days of his life because there's fucking blood and raw meat all over his kitchen and his mother-in-law is covered in blood and shrieking at him to the point where he thought he was gonna have to hit her, which would be deeply traumatizing. And then she's there like, ugh. So that was that video. Clearly it was all fake, really bad, really lazy. It's typical boring shit, but it's Halloween, you know? You get an excuse to be lazy. It's a rainy day. I'm in my Oscar the Grouch pajamas. I'm not trying too hard today, okay? I'm phoning it in. Happy Halloween. Moving on to a channel I've wanted to cover for quite a while, FV Family. I don't know what that stands for. I don't know if I want to know, because their videos scare me. And they're not even Halloween themed most of the time. But today we got a Halloween themed one where they put killer clowns in the backyard as a prank on their kids, their young children. Let's scare the shit out of our kids and film it. That's my favorite kind of content. Which is strange, right? Because like obviously these things are painted to be real, or at least like semi-real. Like you're not supposed to think going into the video that the kids are in on it. It's obvious in most cases that they are, but that's not what they're trying to portray, regardless of how hard they actually do try. But I feel like the internet would be so up in arms if I put out a video scaring the shit out of my dog. Like if my dog was just walking around the corner and I screamed in his face and scared him and he ran away whimpering. I feel like people would hate that. I feel like they'd be so mad at me, and rightfully so. I would hate that. Like why is it acceptable to do it to kids? Like I know kids are the reason that these videos are popular in the first place, are the ones watching them, but still it's just like, I don't know, maybe we shouldn't do that. It's portrayals of abuse basically, but it's fake, but kids don't know that.
The following footage you are about to see occurred on Halloween 2016.
This is a video from 2016? God damn, FV Family's fucking rolling out the old ones and they don't even give a shit.
It's me, Funnel Dad.
Alright guys, listen here. I'm gonna try to be a scary, creepy clown.
And surprise my kids!
Usually, they catch on to these things. They say, oh, that's just daddy. That's why I brought some friends along. Oh, boys!
I love this graphic, just too little. The age difference between it being okay and it not being okay is like 2 years, but too little. And the other one's a baby. He has nerves of steel. I can't shake him.
All right, now it's time to set up some hidden cameras. We got one hidden by this little ghost guy here. Put one in the tombstone. Got a couple other ones hidden too. Mom's got one. Heading to the woods. It's time to set up. Prepare. Bat of juggling. Those are feet. That's a clown. Those are leaves. That's a tree. There's another clown. My goodness, I think you get the point.
What are you doing? Stop! This is just an example of more padding the runtime. Like, you can just cut this part out. You're literally saying out loud what's happening, and I'm getting no information from it. It's so pointless. I hate kids' content. Get this off of the internet. Delete it, and put this nostalgia critic-looking-ass guy in jail.
He sees him, but maybe he's not too sure because the trampoline is probably blocking his view. This is crazy. If I saw this when I was a kid, I would probably be peeing in my pants.
If I saw this when I was a kid, I would have hated my dad and my mom and anyone who let it happen. I would grow up to resent them and I would move out at the age of 18. I love these little, like, subtle admissions of guilt.
Then he books it. Run, Mike! Run!
What's the matter? Mike, why didn't you get it?
There's clowns out in the woods. Now I just know you're pranking me.
What are you talking about?
Oh my God. The kid is crying. He's not only crying because of what's happening. He's crying at the situation. He's like, you guys are pranking me and I hate it.
We interrupt this throwback. No, no. I just found this out. Mike just told me recently that he was acting.
Hey, that was in my prime time. You know, I got the solar eclipse going.
I can't see anything.
You know, we got that crying scheme. So, it's flowing. I never told him though. Like, I had to make the video interesting.
I had no idea, but he told me that his whole time he was in on it.
And fucking Nostalgia Critic has to pull up and be like, wait, this kid was acting. I highly fucking doubt that, asshole. I think you just emotionally abused your son and then felt a little funny about uploading it 5 years after the fact, and so you made him tell the camera that he was just acting. Like, I'm sorry, dude, you're just a piece of shit. Thanks for justifying it, though. Fuck you, Nostalgia Critic. I'll probably do a whole video on FV Family, but I don't know if it'll get worse than this. I certainly fucking hope not. Let's move on to our last video for today. Instead of focusing on children, we're gonna be talking about adults who behave like children. That's right, the Dobre Twins, everyone's favorite pieces of cardboard with a YouTube channel. Do not call me Ethan the Grouch in the comments. Do not do it. I will straight up fuck you up, dude. I will fuck you up.
I'm on your way.
What are you doing?
I'm bored. Okay. I was wondering if you're trying to come swim with me or something.
Okay, I don't want to imply anything, but this is a little homoerotic.
Hey, bro, I'm just bored. I was just wondering if you wanted me to get in bed with you. Come on, let's swim.
I'm coming.
Bro, look at the pool. I'm gonna turn on the lights, okay?
Bro, why do you want to do this?
Because I'm bored. I have nothing else to do.
All right, let's get in.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's fine. I'm doing it for you.
Hey, whatever, bro. I just wanted to hang out with you. Yo, it's hot.
Are we getting in?
Yeah, let's do it.
Bro.
What?
All right, nothing.
I'd be pissed if someone woke me up and be like, I'm bored. Can we go to the pool and film it? No! Motherfucker, we cannot!
Alright. Hopefully I don't wake up anymore.
Are you coming in too?
Yeah, I'm
coming. Oh.
Yo, it's crazy.
Yeah, be quiet. You're gonna wake everyone up.
God help me if I ever make a video where I flop into my multi-million-dollar pool at 10 p.m. pretending it's 3 a.m. only to timidly crawl out and say, that was crazy. I got the pool.
I'm kind of scared. Do you hear that police siren?
Yeah, it's fine, bro. It's late.
Are you sure?
Yeah, stuff happens at night. Bad stuff. All right, anyways. I want to see how long you can hold your breath for.
Yeah, man, bad stuff happens at night. Poor people shit. Don't worry about it, dude. They'll see how long you can't hold your breath. What the Dobre brothers have in common with Shane Dawson, hopefully not too much, but what they do have in common for sure, they don't hire an editor, apparently. They just let the camera roll. It's been like 5 minutes. Has anything happened? No. No, it has not.
All right. 3, 2.
I want to see if you could beat my record of 45 seconds.
Bro, your head is steaming right now.
Really?
Yeah. It looks like it's steaming.
I literally feel like I'm watching someone's fucking camera roll on their phone right now. What is happening? Is this content? Is this 500,000 views? Oh, finally. 6 minutes in and something's happening.
Did you actually not hear that?
No. Did you hear something?
Yeah, did you?
Stop lying.
I'm not lying, I swear. Hello?
I like to imagine that there's actually a fucking home intruder at the Dobre complex, and they just can't figure out who's messing with who, so they just both get fucking robbed.
Can I help you?
Can we help you? Yeah, I'm looking for him right now. Yeah, the cops are after you right now. You trying to leave?
Alright, that's not bad. That's pretty funny, actually. Hey, man, you know the cops are looking for you, right? No? They won't find me.
Yo, chill.
Oh, yo. Wait, Marcus. Hold on. It's Christian. Hold up. It's Christian.
What are you doing? That's not funny. Are you scared?
Marcus or whoever, whichever one this is, I don't fucking know. But he looks so actually upset. I'm pretty sure he's still bullshitting. But I just love you. Just like, no, dude. You fucking woke me up for this. This sucks. And then to reconcile, his brother tells him what happened with the prank.
Yeah, come here. Let me tell you what happened. So I thought of a funny prank that Christian pranks you while we go swimming and then we scare you.
Okay.
Was that good?
That's what happened. I like to imagine like you get into a really bad fight with like your best friend. Like you steal his girlfriend, you steal money from him, you come up to him and you're like, hey man, I just want to make this right. And he's like, no, there's nothing you can do. And I'm like, listen, please. Basically what happened was I stole your girlfriend and then I took $500 from your bank account. And that's the truth. Like, we all know what happened. We just saw it happen. All right, that sucked. Happy Halloween. Today's comment of the video is from Later Babes, who says, hate misogynists, love this video. If you want to be featured in a future video, please go ahead and just leave a comment. I will see you next week for the first video of November. That's going to be exciting, won't it? Nope. Bye.
For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.